And I just wanted to show you something which I've been doing the last couple of days. Well, figured it out last night, finally. Morn is with me. Dom might be dropping back in a minute. I don't know. Just switched PCs. So basically, been trying to make money in various ways. I've done a bit of mining, which I'm still not very good at. A bit of exploration, which takes up a bit of time. And then combat, which is only really any good if you're in wings or if you have a big ship, which I don't. And we're not all often in a large wing. There's usually only about three of us on at any time. So I wanted to check out trading again. Now, I used to do bulk trading and rares, but rares are a bit repetitive. And bulk trading really only works when you have a really big ship again. So I've been using this recently. This is the Type 6 Lacon. It's a nice little ship. You can fit it out for various different things. But what I've been using it for is short run, or, well, they're long range really, like 150 light year hauls. And I want to show you how I found the station. I mean, this may be common knowledge. It probably is. But basically, this is, we're going to get into it. So I'll put a timestamp that will skip to after we've done this section, and then hopefully if you want to skip this bit, you can. So we're going to go into the galactic map. Now, it doesn't matter what faction you're with, okay? So if I just put it on power play and zoom out, you can see all the areas there. If you're pledged to a power, just go show headquarters, and it'll take you to the nearest one to you, I believe. There is obviously one with an icon on it, which is the actual headquarters somewhere. There it is. This is my headquarters at QBO. And effectively, what we're going to do is just imagine that shape. There's the shape. So there's a circle coming around here. Obviously, it's a sphere, really. You know, if we were to rotate this, then you'd be able to see more. But I'm now going to go into the map. And I'm going to go to government. No, not government, sorry. Allegiance. And then we're basically going to turn off everything but the faction you're with. So here I'm with Empire. So this will help for your standings and that. So see there, all these blue stars, they're all Empire. So we're going to go right to the edge of Empire. Okay, and we can turn this around and get an idea for it. So there's a lot of them. There's loads of them. And what you want is you want one right on the edge. Right on the edge of the black. Because obviously out there is exploration territory. Okay. Obviously, there's far more stars, but these are the last ones with stations. Okay, so like this one here, what is it? I'm going to Zendi. I've done like six missions there, and after six missions, they're offering me 1.6 million for legal goods, not slaves. You know, you probably get even more for them if they were there. So now they don't all have these missions, but most of them do. So if you just go along the edge, I mean, there's hundreds of them going around the edge of this space. You just keep going and look, they just keep lighting up. There's loads of them. And they're all the way around every territory. So that being said, all right, what I'm going to do is I'm going to fly up there now. We'll take a quick look at the ship before we leave. It's really simple stuff, so it won't take long. Again, there'll be a timestamp in the description to skip this part. And then, basically, like I say, I had 2.5 million last night. So, you know, this should be pretty easy to show. If I go into the outfitting real quick. We're faceless, so we've got no guns. Got one chaff, just in case. Just in case something scary pulls us out. But, touch wood, we're usually okay. So, I got an A-spec. Okay, so it's all A. Biggest fuel tank you can fit on it is the 16. And then for the optional, we're going to go with the 5D shield generator because it's only 8 tons. We've switched... oh, wait, hang on. Didn't get the top there. 5C fuel scoop. So that picks up a lot. It's 410 or something per second. So you can pretty much fill up the whole of what you've used each time you hit a star. So 5D... like I say, 8 tons. 32, used the 2.4s for 16s to give me 32. Plus the 8 in the 3 rack gives me 40 tons of cargo space. Most of these missions will be between, well, up to 33, I usually find. So it's just more, one more than 32, because they want to get you. You know what I mean? you know, they've worked this out up at Frontier. We take the advanced discovery scanner, mostly just because I like to scan it while I'm jumping. It's just something to me. It makes a noise. And also, like I say, I'd usually use that for the exploration fit. Then the planetary vehicle, I like the Scarab. I'm a bit of a tourist. Like, again, you could drop this and for something else, and you could drop these and save, like, I think it's 6 tons for the lightweight hanger. So you'd get a bit more out of it. And like I say, that gives me 22.2 fully loaded and 26.2 light years unladen. So, right. So that's that out of the way. We've already got the target. We've already got it all locked up. So here we go. 6 jumps to Zendi. And this is the point where you put on your space jazz. All right. Hopefully we won't get wrecked as soon as we leave the first station.
Landing restraints retracted. You are reminded to observe safe speeds when traversing the docking bay.
Whoop, we're on the joystick now. Right then.
And meanwhile, he's doing the trade runs, I'm doing exploration out on the east side.
What have you found?
Well, currently I found a T-Tori with 6 gas giants and no planets.
Oh wow. 6 gas giants but no planet.
And they don't have rings as well.
Huh.
All class 1. Oh no, this is water-based life.
He's found life in another dimension.
Yay!
Right, this is gonna be a bit weird because last night I was playing on a trackball mouse, which is actually surprisingly good in this game because it holds the angle you want it to stay on. Sort of like having a joystick that doesn't spring back and just kind of stays wherever you leave it. So it's actually quite good for this game, especially with interdiction. So I'll probably get wrecked on the interdiction today, because I'm not used to it. We need to get quicker on the jumps as well, I think. So, max speed to Zendi. And like I say, once I get there, like when I started there, I was doing 450,000, I think it was, for a 100 light year run. And I took a couple of those. And then I went, I'll take like 3 at once, and was taking 1.2 million per run. I didn't bother bringing anything back because it's only 6 jumps. Like, I've seen all of these routes where they send you off all over the place to get like this 100k here and 100k there. And yeah, sure, that's fine. But I find it takes longer to fly from the star to a station than it does to turn around and fly all the way back. You know, I could, in the amount of time it takes somebody to land, you could probably go all the way back to where you came from. So,
For me, landing is like 1 to 2 minutes from arrival.
But it depends. Yeah, but it depends how far.
Yeah, it depends on the distance.
Yeah, because exactly, because if the station is like, what was it, over 10,000 light seconds from the star, you're going to be flying for a good few minutes. You know.
How much?
I don't know, 7?
7,000 takes 3.5 minutes.
Ah, right. Well, anyway, it certainly doesn't... Because we've worked out we can jump, what was it, 100 light years in 8 minutes? If you really go for it?
Around there, yeah. I mean, from this 700 light years, I could get back in 23 minutes.
Because there's ways to go faster. Like, if you go in to scoop the star, it slows you down. If you immediately turn away from the star and then accelerate to 0.75C, hit jump, and then start looking for the target, you don't even need to move yet. Because once you're away from the star, it doesn't matter what direction you go in. So we'll align now.
Yep.
And then we're off. So, you know, count it down. I'll do the next one quick. I think I've got enough fuel to make it all the way there now. Oh, yeah, I gotta wait. So we'll hot jump the next one and see what happens.
And in these hot jumps, we need ice cream. Just right, like the one I'm having.
There we go, pull away. Get that star behind me. Accelerate to 0.75. Hit the jump button, find the point. Sometimes you end up jumping back towards the star. It's quite funny. Right, and we're off. I always find I get interdicted less if I align after I've charged as well. If I align before I've charged, I'm sat there flying in a straight line. And
I can confirm that.
Yeah, and then even if it's not a player, the NPCs will get you quicker. So let's just fly casually past here.
So also before docking, you know, the trade lines. If you follow the Congo line, you will be more likely to be interdicted.
Right, so get out the shipping lanes. Right.
There was one system, one. I even screenshotted it, where I had like 25 to 30 ships in a Congo line, like in a trade room. And it was like, wow, is there that many stars? Nope.
I just done Kubio to Zendi in like 10 minutes. Must have been less. It didn't even feel like that far at all. Alright, well, it's just gone 5 o'clock. You can see up in the timer there, 1700. So, let's get our asses to this station and I can show you what's what. And then, obviously, this system works anywhere in the whole galaxy. So, the advantage is, if you find that you're not getting the missions or whatever, you can just go to the next one and repeat the process. So, you'll never run out of things to do. Like, the thing I found about bulk trading was that the item you were trading would run out. Or, like the item you were trying to trade would it would go down in value or run out of stock, okay?
Oh yeah, and if your trading formation was too old, then there was no item.
Yeah, that too. So,
against that, one can use the ED Market Connector. So. You actually refresh the database for everyone else to use as well.
Yeah, that would be nice, wouldn't it? Oh, damn, I think I just broke my joystick. Yeah, I think I just broke my throttle lever again. Oh, well.
Oh, no!
It doesn't like it when you use the keyboard to set the throttle. And it's my reflex is to set the throttle. I go X and W when I get to 10 seconds till it's blue.
Oh, right. Well, it does like it. I mean, it doesn't break it. You just have to move it all the way to trigger it again.
Oh, okay.
You know, full forward, full back, and then set it back.
Oh, okay.
To where you want it.
Well, I'll wait, because I don't... This is the funny thing. I find it more accurate to use X, W, and S when you're coming into land. I mean, I don't know.
Definitely. One can use the hotkeys as well, yeah.
So there's pros and cons for mice or joysticks. I don't think really either is better than the other. Because if you're good with a mouse, like this trackball I've been using for development and 3D and like all that sort of stuff, is a lot more accurate. Like it takes a while to get used to them. Once you're used to them,
but then they get more accurate.
Yeah, it's actually crazy. Wait, we've got to go down and under here. I think no. Which way is it? It's closer. Okay. Right, we're here. Dropping out. So, what was it you told me? Anti-clockwise, so it's that face. It's a good tip, that.
Definitely, yes.
And my throttle's back working again. Yay! Right, max thrust, let's get in there. Okay, give me permission to dock. Oh no, they're scanning me.
So three class one and one water based life.
Oh wow. Well done.
And two icy moons.
I think I went too fast. It's all good. I'm still like, it's weird going from a joystick to a mouse to a joystick all the time. That'll do.
So on to COL173 sector.
That was the rustiest dock. I swear that this thing doesn't turn as much with my joystick as well. But whatever. We'll figure it out.
Although, you know, the speed makes it more turnable on it. Because balance. I mean, if it would be linear, you know, from zero you turn the best and from there on you only turn less, I would understand that.
It might be dead zone. It might be there's a dead zone on it that I haven't trimmed because all the bindings changed when I started playing it on my main PC.
Oh, yeah.
Like my laptop's got completely different bindings to my main because obviously I don't use a joystick or a laptop. Imagine that sat in a cafe somewhere with two joysticks and a laptop. What?
I only left baseball caps and shades in buses.
Right, well, here we are. We are now at Viewer Sunday Survey, sorry, in Zenday. It's a lovely...
The first Y class I found.
Oh, nice, Y class. They're my favourite. You got to get a bit of Y hole in your life. Okay, so basically what we got here is the mission board for Zendy. So if you've just skipped to this section, welcome. You've just skipped seven jumps. So what do we got? Defense force of Zendy. So what do we got? We got 8 units of Galite for 715 and 18 units of Lepidolite for 857,000 each. So that's obviously what, 1.5 million for 26 units, and I've still got 40. So that means I could take another, and they're both going to Tabalban, which is 141 light years. So we're going to take these without question. Howard Horizons Outpost. And we'll take the other one as well. And then I'll look through the other guys and see if there's anybody else going to Tabalban. So just have a little drink. Got a bit of a cold, guys. So I'm medicating myself with Coca-Cola. Right, so HIP 9G Carine, no go. Tabalban, only 284,000 though. Is it going to Cochrane? I don't know. I don't think that's the same place I was already going to. Next guy, Zendy.
Did you go to the same place?
Yeah, I'm at Zendy at the minute. Aha! Look, I found one. 9 units of Galite. For the new Zendy Liberals, 429,000 for 9 units of Galite. So now we're touching on 2 million for this run. So, let's gamble! This is where it gets fun, because I could die and lose everything. Should we see what the potential fine's going to be?
Do you fly without insurance?
What do you mean, do I fly without insurance?
Do you have enough money to pay for your insurance?
Oh, yeah, I've got like 12 million credits. Insurance is not
then,
a big deal.
Then it's safe.
Yeah, I know. Look, see the...
You only lose the mission.
273,000 rebuy. If I look at the... don't make me rage about this thing again. How do you turn it off? How do you stop it from putting focus in the chat? What? How do you do that?
Okay. Options.
What, in the game options?
Yeah, go to options.
All right, options, yeah.
Controls.
Oh man, I can see, I can hear Cowboy Bebop, mate. It's cool. What'd you say?
In the options.
Yeah.
Go choose miscellaneous.
Yeah.
And on the bottom, enable context menu off. Oh no, that's not it. It's somewhere here. Hold on, I'm gonna find it.
Alright. So yeah, just to let you know, basically I had a little rant about how when you press 2, it puts you into the chat, and sometimes you really needed to get to the tabs, and Q and E, it just goes QE, QE, QE. Or 1, because you're trying to put it away. So apparently there's a way to turn that off, so I'm just going to try and do that. Nested toggle. Well, let me know and we'll come back to it, okay?
Okay.
Because I can't find it right now. All right. Let's get back to it, guys. Okay. So we've got our mission. So first thing I want to do... Oh, God, I just did it again. Get out of there! Right. I'm trying to get here. Okay. So the galley is going to Cochrane. So let's open the map and set our destination. Pretty simple stuff. Oh, look, it's giving us a system map. Sometimes it doesn't give you a system map, and that's why I've got the advanced discovery scanner. I just remembered about that. Sometimes you'll go to a system to make a delivery, and the planet won't be there because no one's scanned it yet. So obviously, if you have an advanced,
yes,
in
but
one
the
click...
the station will be. Oh, yeah, I found it.
No, it just tells you which planet to go to. And if
no, I find the toggle.
Oh, did you? Where is it?
It's in the mode switches, autofocus on text input field.
Mode switches, huh? That's weird. There's no mission thing here. Hang on a minute. It's taking me to the wrong one, hasn't it? Hang on. Cochrane Outpost. Maybe it's going to change my destination en route. It might do that to me, and then that will make everything really fun. See, why are we on Zendi? Look. Some kind of bug going down here. There. Hello? Right. That's weird. Is that where I'm supposed to be going? No.
Mode switches.
It's not in the Empire. Hang on a minute.
Oh, sorry, sir.
Hang on a minute. Put it back to star type. Wow, it's not even a scoopable star, whatever this is. Okay, so fill none. To Balban. There we go, we finally got him. And yeah, we've got no scans. So plot route, 141 light years. So what I had to do there, guys, was I had to turn off the filter because it wasn't an Empire station and it wasn't a scoopable star, so it wasn't showing up on the map. So it did look a bit weird. I had that be confused for a sec there, but yeah, there you go, filters. So let's put it back on star class because I like knowing where I have to go for fuel. It looks like I can make it there on a single tank again because there's no dotted line. So technically I don't need to scoop. I could just sprint the whole way there, but I will be scooping because for say, you know, it's always good to, especially when I'm going to end up in a system with no ability to scoop it. And then the other thing is just to check what the other locations are. So we've got Cochrane Outpost. Cochrane Outpost, good, and Howard's Horizon. So we've got two different destinations. All right. I'll see if I could squeeze any more on the ship. We got 5 units left, and I haven't seen a mission for less than 5 on the board.
I love how they give you one day to complete them.
Oh, man, I failed once. I logged off, and I was like, it's all right. I'll do it tomorrow. And then by the time I got back on my machine, it had been more than 24 hours. It's like, or however long it was. It's like, damn!
Yeah, but it's better than Farmville, you know.
Yeah, that's right. And what's the potential fine here? So there's no fine for that? That's weird. Normally it tells me there's going to be a fine if I fail, but not anymore. Okay. Absolutely.
There is sometimes a fine and sometimes
no negative repercussions, guys. Right, so There'll be a timestamp most likely for here, so welcome if you skip the whole thing. We're now going to take our combined, I think it's a 2 million credit haul, and we're going to be going...
Yeah, you're going to draw some pirates.
8 jumps to Balbon, and to Balbon is not a friendly system or scoopable, so let's do this. Oh man, I love this part. This is the gamble, guys. 2 million credits are in the air right now. And it's 7 jumps away. I can almost taste the credits.
Detachment sequence complete. You are clear for departure.
Which is actually about 1 to 2 hours of combat farming.
Right.
So it's not nothing.
Yeah. And we went out exploring for like 6 hours with really good kit. And we ended up with a couple million?
Well, 3-4 hours and 1.5 million, yeah.
Where's my boost button? That's flight assist. See, this is why I end up using the keyboard. Oh, wait. There we go. Landing gear. My go, my bad. Turn the other way. Okay. Power to systems and... There we go. Let's get out of here. Is that Federation? No, Empire Security Service. He's alright. I love the smack talk the NPCs give you as well. They're like, oh, I've been waiting a long time for you.
Yeah, and sometimes it's like, I'm not going home hungry tonight.
Yeah.
And when you kill them, you're being morbid. It's like, you're definitely not going hungry tonight.
My god, I actually lined so quick, it was still cooling down. Alright. Yu Shanwen. I should have scanned it. We'll scoop this one, I think, if we can. Yeah, we can. So, scoop. Oh, no, no, you can't scoop this one. Okay, speed up to 7.5. This was a big one. Align. Okay. Keep an eye on the scanners. So far, so good. I always remember the first time I played this game. We got another channel called MushroomFleet Elite Dangerous, where I put up a bunch of videos from the first time I played the game, when it was back in beta or alpha or whatever it was then. And I'll always remember when I flew, I did this one, Eagles to Seoul, where I flew in an eagle from wherever you start all the way to Seoul, and I had the fuel scoop all the way there. And the joke is, because I knew nothing about the game, I had one of the ships with the worst jump range, with one of the worst jump drives, with one of the worst fuel scoops in the game, and I'm like flying around the sun, absolutely loving this fuel scoop, even though it's taking me so long that it's just a joke, you know. I would have been I would have been dead. Yeah. I was just lucky no one caught me. But it just makes you look back, because it's one of those games where there's a learning curve, and you do die a lot at the beginning, but. If you find something like this, which is a nice ship, I mean, you can start off doing these runs in a hauler, which costs significantly less than the Type 9.
And still can haul some cargo.
And it can still haul, and it still has a good jump range. So...
A very good one at best.
You just won't be able to get as big a fuel scoop on it, that's all. There we go, we're scooped up, let's get out of here.
Well, refueling is not that costly at stations.
And jump. So, scan the system, we're going to race. D-scan, jump drive, race. Nothing found. I've already scanned the crap out of these routes, because it sent me like 7 different ways. And I scanned them all and handed the data in at QBO.
Yeah, if you want to raise your faction popularity, you know, that they like you, just turn in a lot of exploration data and they will love you for it.
Yeah, they will. It's the, you want to probably, because it took me, I couldn't figure out how to rank it up.
When I get back, I turn it all into the duel.
Exactly, yeah, turn in your exploration data at your faction HQ station. You'll get more gains. Like, I took me ages to
Or if you don't go into power play, just dump it off at the Empire or the Star Federation or the Alliance. Because it does matter.
Yeah, whichever your... I did show him how to do that at the beginning. How to find the...
Yeah, and it was on the last stream as well.
Yeah. Yeah, because this is so faithful to the original game, it's just got a hell of a lot more depth and better graphics.
Also, when you're going into the faction base in power play, you can just grab 10 units of, you know, fortification.
What's that?
I already did. Well, the power play changed, you know, where you have to fortify and undermine and prepare systems for the faction takeover.
I don't know how I had to do any of that, I'll be honest. I haven't
and,
done any of it.
The undermining goes like killing the opponent. The fortification goes like bringing material to the fortifiable planet from the home base. And preparation goes that from the home base you go out to the planets or systems that you want to prepare to be captured, you know.
Yeah.
So it's basically hauling at
the island.
Well,
I
don't know
we've
the
got
other
a customer.
Factions.
I think we might have a customer. Got a Viper Mark 4.
Oh, he wanted a piece of you?
I don't know. I'm just checking. He is pretty close. I mean, there was a bit of a weird... Nah, he's not going for me. There was a weird gravity thing going on.
Oh, yeah, it does.
When I came off that particular star, it slowed me down abnormally. And when I was doing the jump, it just wasn't really accelerating, so I had to cancel it and spool up a second time. Okay, so... Let's get some fuel here. Next jump is to Balban. Whoa, this is a big system. I love those solar flares! Okay. Here we go, cruising round, full tank of gas, and we're heading to our last destination. So this will be the fun part. Obviously, I haven't been jumped yet, and I've had no updates. Sometimes it will tell you to go somewhere else. Who's that? Is he coming around? Whenever I see a little yellow thing on the radar, I'm like, who are you? Where are you going? It's all right, he's going away from us.
Certainly, I can't yet see you on the map.
Oh really? Why not? You should be able to.
I don't know. Maybe
you're just...
You know, I'm open play.
Ah. Makes sense.
Are you on the private group?
Yeah, mate. There's like 30 of us in this group. It's good stuff.
Oh, I know, I know.
Right. Okay, so now we're finally here. Don't know why it said that, but whatever. Okay, so Cochrane Plant is my first one. Let's get going. Wait, is that a planet? Should probably do the planet. No, it's not. That's alright. It's a platform. Okay, let's get going.
So I got 6 metal-rich planets, a class 1 giant, and lots of icy stuff on this quad system.
That one's getting closer as well. Oh no, now it's getting further away. Nope, now it's getting closer. I don't know, I think I get the feeling that these stations are quite close, these two. So where's the third? Is there a third? No, it's 2 at Cochrane and 1 at Howard. That's right. Okay. So again, I'm going to cut to zero when I'm at 10 seconds, and then I'll accelerate up until I hit the blue line. That's pretty much how we're going to do this.
If you set 75%, you can just toggle there.
No, I'm not, because the throttle stick stopped working again. So I'm probably going to overshoot it a bit now. Thanks for that. Right.
Dolphin.
Dolphin dive. See the halo and then drop back up. Shit, now I got people on me big time. That was a mistake. I think we can save it though. We're just going to have to be creative. Okay, time for another one. Wait for the halo. Pull up a little bit. Wait till I get control back. There we go. And now, get it in the bottom of the blue. That was messy. And now watch my radar like a hawk, because I got a few seconds to not get done in.
I had that once. I was like 1 second to jump out and they interdicted, and the interdiction tunnel just dragged me away from the station.
Oh man.
And I was like, no!
Not allowed.
I was
I'm about to log. I'm about to go here. I'm about to dock. And they're like, can you get them here sooner? Optional time
within
left.
A minute, right?
No, 0 hours, 0 minutes.
Oh yeah, that means 45 seconds.
What?
Yeah, usually.
I don't even care about the bonus.
It's under a minute, you know?
It's a pathetic bonus.
Oh, you just arrived. Can you dock under a minute?
Yeah, you can dock under a minute.
Yeah, but that's a fast docking. If
but I had to read the bloody... Well, I had to read the bloody message first.
Yeah. I don't even read it usually.
So where's this landing pad then? You know? Like, seriously, where's the landing pad? One, three. Look at it. Oh, you failed to get the bonus, it says. Are you gonna stop or what? No, you're not. You don't feel like stopping. Oh my god! Something's a bit wrong here. Have I had it set up to... Yeah, I think I know what might have been going on. Alright. And that means it's fixed now. Yeah, I think I had it set up for full range when I needed to have it set up for... Why is this making the ship turn? This should be strafe. Oh my goodness. The bindings are all kinds of messed up since that... reinstall. All right, here we go.
Just fun and things, right?
Yeah, I actually stop at zero now. That's good. Okay. So first, no, not outfitting. Dum dum da dum dum dum.
Dom's not here.
No, I said dumb. I just went into outfitting when I don't need to. Whatever, I'll get off the pad. Someone else can use it. Okay, so... back. Refuel. Mission board. Deliver. The bonus doesn't matter because you're getting paid so much money, like 75,000 credits isn't for a fast dock, is a bit of a... What's that? That's not even 10%. It's like 1%. It's not even half a percent bonus. I'll give you a 0.5% bonus if you land really quick. All right. So that was 894,000. And now...
What? Yep. On the same time, I gathered information for 120,000 about the system.
Wow, and I got 429 as well at the same station. So that's 1.3 mil, roughly. And now.
Well, I'm only 7 jumps from my destination, so then I head back.
Okay. Well, 1 point. So that's 1.3, and then I've just got to go to the other station in the system, which is a planet landing, I think. Is it, or is it just another station? No, it's just another station. Only 29 light seconds as well. So this shouldn't take long. And then that'll be 2 million, which is not bad for just flying in a straight line.
A whole brick's price.
It's the brick, mate. The brick. The power of the brick.
So in 20 minutes, you get back the whole ship's price?
Yeah.
Nice.
And it'll get better as well if you had if I level
this
guy up.
Yeah, if you have a good reputation,
yeah.
You get better deals.
I mean, they didn't even give me a 1.5 million mission in one go this time. They made me, like, take a whole bunch of them. Wow, we're, like, right next to it. Yep, it's right there. Okay, let's go.
Wow, this is just a single star. That was rare.
So what do we got up here? Prismatic Imperium reputation change. You are
a lone Titori.
Oh wow, I'm now cordial with Imperium.
Well done.
So whereabouts is that? I always play this little game. Is that at the back of the ring or at the front of the ring? And I think it's at the back of the ring.
Check if what part of the ring is masked by the planet, and then you can speculate.
And then I also go under the ring as well. Like, it's a sphere. I imagine it's a sphere.
Oh, yeah.
Because otherwise it'll slow you down if you go inside the sphere that this circle here is indicating, the one going around the planet. So you'll slow down. I don't want to slow down. I want to get to the station quick because they're going to steal my gold.
So what were you saying about the rare goods?
Rare goods? What about them?
You said that you can lose them by scanning?
No.
Or something like that?
No. I said I used to do rares.
I just got it.
I said I used to do rares, but to be honest, it's boring.
This is better.
You just go round in a circle, and to be honest, you don't earn that much unless you have, like, you know, hundreds of cargo space, not less than 100, you know? So it just becomes a bit... Yeah, it's a bit repetitive because you have to fly really, really long. I mean, I could do rares with this thing, but you're only able to pick up a couple, and you don't make that much. So, like, unless you're in a Type 9 or a Type 7, maybe? I've never flown a Type... It is a Type 7, isn't it?
21 objects.
Is it? Yeah, there's one in between the 9 and this one. And I think it's got a bit more cargo.
And it's undiscovered as well.
Okay.
It's got one rocky and a lot of ice planets and one gas giant. Doesn't really worth it.
Right, is that my one or is that just another one that happened to also... That is 3. Right, we're going to do a dirty landing, guys. Get ready. Yeah, like a pro. That's how you land in the 45 seconds, Martin.
Okay, I will watch it.
You ditch it.
Back.
Oh, yeah. It helps if you put your landing... Wait, I have my landing gear on.
I mean, yeah, my record is 46 seconds.
Well, if I'd been paying attention, it would have been a lot quicker, but yeah. You just like dive bomb, and then you stop dead right in the
was
middle.
Was it the Coriolis or?
No. You can. It's easier in them though, because they've got like a baseball mitt of a little building behind your pad that you can just headbutt.
Yes.
It's funny. Used to call it full throttle docking. Used to do it for fun in Sidewinders.
No, it's shield testing docking.
Yeah. Just make sure you put your pips into the systems. Yeah. Okay, so...
Oh, I just did this for you, dear station, because I want to pay for the repairs.
Yeah, right.
Let's boom that economy.
Yeah, it's a boom delivery, mate. Boom time.
boom, get your cargo off.
Yeah.
I mean, what would you say if Frontier would introduce that you have to wait for the loading and unloading of goods?
Oh God, that'd be annoying. I wouldn't like that. I like being able to just come in and leave. It's bad enough that I've got to turn all the way around and go out the other way.
Oh, you get to unload in 10 minutes.
To Balban.
That would be funny.
Right, so basically that's the run, guys. And then from this point, I can just fly back and see what they got. So that's pretty much what I'm going to do. I'm just going to
Yeah, but take back. Something they want over there.
Nope, there's going to be nothing for those people here. Trust me.
Oh, okay.
I suppose I could look, but because I'm sent to different places every time, I was saying this before, it's almost
okay.
There's no point. I may as well just fly back. Like, it's...
Yeah, because you make enough.
Yeah, because I've just made like 2 million in one run. I mean, geez.
So you don't want a 20k profit?
No,
route?
Like a 20, yeah, 20k profit route going back. What's 20k? I just made 2 million in 7 jumps. I'm not interested.
It's just funny.
I'll just fly back now. Because like
just
when
five
I,
jumps away.
Because the thing is, when I was doing the bulk trading with 100 cargo, making 100,000 per run was good. Yeah. On one jump. So I've just done 7 right. jumps, that would be 700,000. So that means this is actually twice as good. Well,
yes.
Almost, or more. All right, let's get the hell out of here.
And if you don't go back to the same station again and again, then you get more and more offers. Although, no, you have to go back to the same because they like you more.
Yeah, they like me more, but eventually, if they don't have any missions, I can just go and work on another station next to it. There's like 10 of them right next to it. Because all I'm doing is I'm going to the outer rim and I'm doing courier missions to the interior. That's like Millennium Falcon stuff, that is, right there.
Definitely. You're just not smuggling yet.
I'm just not smuggling, yeah.
Have you tried smuggling yet?
I don't think it's a good idea, I'll be honest. I think you get wrecked real fast.
Well, not if you can do stealth docking stuff.
I suppose so.
It's a mastery, you know, you have to master it. But when you do, you can just blindfoldedly land on a Coriolis. And also it helps if they want you to deliver dark goods for low security systems.
Raise the cordial. Uh-oh, we're in the menu again. Come on. There we go. Oh, we're on a new route, are we? And that's the other thing as well, right? You'd think when you're going out that you'd take the same route coming back, but of course you don't. Because when you're on your way out, you're full of cargo and you take a lot of shorter hops. So that means you hit different systems on the way back when you're empty.
Okay? Definitely.
Because
especially
it's 25
if you choose optimized.
I don't. I choose quickest route always. Always.
I know.
Even though I'm not paying attention right now. It's funny. I'm going really slow. I'm like waiting for ages to hit J and stuff. It's because I'm ill, guys. I'm sorry. I'm a little bit like...
It's not a speedrun.
I'm a little bit muggy. Yeah, we're just chilling, really. It's just a relaxed... Let's make some money in Elite.
And enjoy yourselves, the most important thing.
Yep. Because, you know, this is essentially flying from point A to point B for a ludicrous amount of cash. I like that.
Sure.
This suspiciously no circle around this star. I'm going to get away from it. I don't like
it. If you don't go fast enough, the circle disappears. And if it's not mineable or scoopable.
I think my throttle stick started not working again. It's funny, mate. I think I need a new joystick. Like, the throttle
Probably.
Lever keeps on
Please
failing.
Please donate it home.
Yeah. No, I think I can
he
cover
needs
it.
A new joystick.
They're only 30 quid. I think I got that covered. Although, do you remember that time my headset broke and someone sent me a new one?
Like, no.
Yeah, it was like the next day. Like, I was doing a live stream and my headset
really?
Broke. Yeah, and an anonymous viewer just
I wasn't with
mailed
you back
it
then.
To me. I thought it was a bit weird, though, because I'd never given my address out.
Well, the thing is, it's not hard. Secret Santa.
Yeah, but it's not hard to find out someone's address these days. I don't know why people go on about doxing and that, because to be honest, it's like your address is probably...
What do you mean?
Doxing. It's where you show off someone's name and address online.
Box, right.
No, DOX.
Oh, okay.
It's something they, like, the cool kids do. They dox you, right? So basically they find your name and address.
They get your address and stuff.
Yeah, and then they put it on a web video or on the internet somewhere. But it's like, if you own, like...
Is this really the cliche now?
Well, yeah, it is, yeah. And people get all offended, like, you can't tell people who I am. And I'm like, hang on a minute, mate. You're in public. You put yourself on the internet. If you own a web...
Yeah.
If you own, like, a web domain,
I mean, it's
or...
a simple ISP query.
Yeah, it's not difficult to work that out. I don't know. It's public domain information. Like... if you just look it up.
But you know, all the non-liberals want their information secret because they're afraid.
Yeah, but this is the funny thing. Like, I find it's mostly people that don't own anything or pay any bills because they don't know that as soon as
because
you own
stuff...
Because
they don't want to lose what they don't have.
but they don't have anything to start with. Like if you... Like, the funny thing is, if you pay bills or have a job or a bank account, like, these things are all registered to you. You know? So that means you're now in the public
unless
domain.
Unless you've given a fake account.
Yeah, but you can't give a fake account to the bank.
To the government.
But you can't.
And
do...
then, you know. Well,
yeah, but that's what I'm saying, though. People that think
that's
like
too
that.
Tricky, yeah.
No, but people that think like that probably haven't ever had a job or. Do you know what I mean?
And gonna die from overstress.
Yeah, they haven't. They haven't actually. Yeah, they've read it somewhere and gone, oh, yeah, that's cool. But the reality is you get paid, you put it in a bank account, and it's registered to your name and address. Like, yeah, oh!
Unless you're a black market worker.
I mean, Christ, if I was like, returns, yeah? Say you have eBay. How do people know where to return stuff if you sell someone?
Yeah, you can't even buy anything without giving your address.
That's what I'm saying, yeah. So it's like... if someone wanted
because
to find out...
Because they don't know where to send it.
Well, yeah, you've got to register your name in so anyone can find out if they want.
Also, I found
somewhere, I don't get it.
Do you really not have ID cards in the UK?
You know, we got driving licenses and passports. And they
but normal citizenship cards.
They were going on about ID cards and they said it was a complete waste of money because that's what a passport is, that's what a driving license is.
And how old are you when you get a passport?
You don't get a passport, you have to buy one, mate.
Oh, I know, but how old is usually when you get it?
No, if you never leave the country, you would never buy one.
And if you don't have a driving license and don't have a passport, you're just unknown and in your birth certificate?
No, you're not unknown. This is what I'm talking about. People think they're off the grid because they haven't got a passport or a driving license.
No, I'm just asking because we have an ID system, you know? That's why it's weird for me if you don't have it.
Well, basically, the ID system is redundant because it only does what driving licenses and passports do. If you're not going anywhere, you're already registered on a council tax register and stuff like that.
Oh, okay.
So, you know...
So you have separate systems.
Yeah, we don't need to tie it all into one thing, because that's just employing a whole bunch of people for doing jobs.
And now you left the EU, so you don't even have to.
Nope.
Because it's
EU
regulation to have one.
I know, we talked about it for years, and then they were like, nah, we're not doing it.
We're too Brit to do it.
It's a waste of money. Well, no, because then I would have had an ID card, a citizenship card, a driving license, a passport, and... I bet there's something else. National insurance card, you know?
Yep.
All they had to do was put a photo on your national insurance card and there's your ID. But they wanted to put biometric information on it, like it needs a slice of my DNA and that guy
sure,
here.
Just
you know
be
the
you know easily stolable.
You know the Archimedes diagram? It'll have a picture of that with like all my measurements and the...
And all the your words that you use the most often. From Facebook, you know?
Yeah, that's right, yeah. And if you touch it, then it's got a QR code for
my social media. It also has the DNA scanner, so if someone else touches it outside of the police, then it evaporates.
Oh, wow. This ID will self-destruct.
Yeah. Please give it back. Although that would boost the glove industry.
The gloves industry don't need a boost because they just make your hands warm or not wet.
Yeah, and that's it prevents gloves. DNA scanning and fingerprinting.
I don't think it does. If I steal your glove, I've got all your fingerprints and your DNA on the inside.
No.
What
I mean, if you're the stealer and you wear a glove, you can't be identified only by your hair samples.
Well, I've seen better than that. You can put a latex fingerprint on a glove and wear that over your finger, and then the heartbeat and the pulse. Because some fingerprints, they check for that, don't they? They check for...
Or you can just do the Doom method.
So, yeah.
Right?
I've still got Doom. I just didn't feel like playing it after I played the first three levels, and
like,
I was like...
Use the official member's hand.
I might try putting the difficulty up. Basically, I didn't die enough. I think that was the reason I didn't jump back on Doom.
Oh, it's not Doomy enough?
Yeah, I think it was a bit too... Gotta go in for the quick attack!
You can turn up. Oh, you can't turn up the difficulty.
Fallout Doom!
Yeah, it's Doom Out 4, mate, isn't it? Doom Out 4? It is! Oh, look, the fucking throttle's broken again. God damn it.
Mate, it's the alternate world. It's the alternate universe of Fallout 4.
I know. Hello, we got some tails. Yeah, we have. We got tails. Right, breaker. This is me. I don't know who I am.
Stop using my jokes. That's not allowed. You're being salty. No.
It's all the meta, mate. All the time. I didn't choose the meta. It chose me.
No, it didn't. You're lying.
Dom, welcome back. We've been wondering where you are. Where have you been, bro?
Browsing the web.
Oh, right. Oh, yeah, did you hear the One Punch specials? There's like 8 of them now.
They've
basically done like another half a series of content in specials while we're waiting for it.
Oh.
Yeah.
Still waiting for it. Won't watch them until the main series comes out, and then I'll watch them all in one go.
They are funny, though, right? There was this one that was completely pointless. It was all about Genos having lost Saitama's keys, and these gangsters had them, and it was so pointless. No, seriously, it was just ridiculous, mate, because the whole episode was basically him telling them all that he's been grocery shopping for Saitama, trying to get the sales, but all the shops were closed, and then he's run into these gangsters and they took his keys. So that was it. I was like, what? It was just like, what the hell? What is this story again? Oh my god, it was funny.
Oh my boy.
It's almost like the writers were like, tell you what, yeah, we'll give you more One Punch, but it won't be what, you know, we'll just give you more One Punch.
Approval granted. You are clear to set down on landing pad 05.
Oh dear. Right, landing gear, please. Let's slow it down. Oh, look, we've got throttle back. That's nice. My throttle is kind of like semi-available. Wait, let me guess. Docking number 5 is right by the entrance, isn't it? Yeah, it is. Bloody annoyance. Screw it. Oh yeah, that's right. We can just do this. Bang! Something tells me that the throttle isn't actually...
No, this system wasn't too much interest. On to the next one.
I don't know. Throttle stick's being a bit weird, mate.
Docking procedure
complete. A light when ready. Enjoy your stay, Commander. Your comfort is our top priority.
Cool. My cold was so bad last night, I couldn't sleep, so I ended up playing this for 3 hours. It was actually
Did
quite
you get
refreshing.
Better?
Yeah, I'm getting a little bit better. I'm just blocked up now, you know.
Hey, so, Tom.
Yeah, mate.
Would you like to play Thunderface?
Thunderface? What, you mean?
Thunderface planes.
You mean Grind Thunder?
Brian Thunder, I was on about for
Oh my god! Look at this mission. I haven't got access to this mission yet, but I've nearly got access to it.
What would it say?
2.5 million for 81 units.
What?
Yeah.
That's only over my besides normal type Tom, 6.
Besides, Tom, I could say that Elite Dangerous is actually Grind Dangerous.
It is Grind Dangerous. I've just been flying backwards and forwards. No, it's not really. I've been flying backwards and forwards.
And you'll be there for months until you finally get your anaconda.
Yes!
What you got, son? But by then, there'll be a bare ship and you've wasted your money.
Oh, look! New Zendi Liberals. 1.1 million for 54 units of bio waste. I don't know why it's offering...
Good luck, my game, blowing up with that stuff.
No, requirements not met. Explosives. I think I might have... Oh, no! There we go. There's another million there for HIP 23641.
And the thing another is, one. With those
I found
100,000
light seconds
from.
Away, yeah. Second star.
What about him?
100,000 light seconds away, star. I'm not going to scan that, right?
Lol, man. So,
sorry.
It's all right. So he's flying in a straight line. Exploration. So what was that, Don?
What?
What did you say? You said the thing is, and then Martin said something.
All right. I was saying that about missions that you make... The only reason you're making so much money is because you've already got the ranks for them, you know, like
oh yeah, but that's
elite
the...
ranks or whatnot.
Oh yeah, but that's the thing though, dude. I've done very little trading to get this far.
Mm-hmm.
To be fair, and I got all this standing last night. I wasn't there with these guys. Like normally, you start off here at neutral. That's where you start. But I have done some missions for Zendi's Silver Mob. Because it goes up with your rank as well. So, like, when I started out, I was only getting 200,000 deliveries. But now, look at this. 23641. Cobble. 21 units of gold. 23641 again. No. Bio waste. Can't do that. Zendi Liberal. Zendi. No. Where's the... A lot of them aren't. Deliveries either. There we go.
But you should play Pokemon Go.
Right. So this one is Bliss Terminal. So I'll take Pokemon Go. So I'll take this one. And there's nothing wrong with Pokemon Go, guys. Calm down. I don't want to insult your interest in Charmander. That's a Pokemon, right? I think it's one from the first episode or something. I watched it with my kid. When I was a kid, it was a big card game, but I wasn't really into card games. Sorry, guys. I played the video games though, and they reminded me a lot of Zelda. Right. So, if I go up here, oh, that guy insulted Pokemon. I'm quitting the stream. Unsubscribe.
Yeah, I'm gonna hack him now.
Yeah, we're gonna dox him, mate. We're gonna tell everyone stuff that's public.
Yeah, all of your two watchers will leave.
Yeah, all two. Take those 4 units of cobalt. So that's a 600,000 haul. And now I have to be clever about my cargo space.
Free jumps.
I think I might have done most of the stuff here now. I might have to find a new station. But like I said, that's easy. There's loads of them. They're everywhere. So... What's up?
No, don't worry about it.
So 21 units of gold, or... Where's the other one gone? I swear there was another mission here somewhere. 21 units of gold. Oh, I guess that's the only one I can have then, is it? Okay. We'll take that. Kind of annoying that Oh, wow, look at... Oh, my God. Boom time deliveries. 2.5 mil in one run.
We love them boom times, right?
Yeah, I mean, I haven't got access to it yet, but I will have. So... Let's get to that wherever the hell they want me to go. See, another good thing about this, I do like it, because you get to go, you don't know where you're going, really. Oh my God, look at this. I've got 4 missions on me. So, 500,000 to Hussey Dock. So let's set that route. Is it? No, there we go. Route. Ah, I'm gonna need to scoop at least once by the looks of it. Ah, nice. All the deliveries are at the close end of the system. Yeah. So Hussey Dock is the furthest away one. Bliss Terminal and Kriegstein. So I guess we'll do Bliss Terminal first because it's closest. No planets either. All stations. Wow, this is a pretty... So I'm going to get attacked then because it's too easy. All right. So, 600,000 for Hussey Dock. 335,000 for Kriegstein. 415 for Kriegstein. And 335 for Bliss. So, really, I want to go to Hussey Dock first. Because that's the most valuable. Damn, I got to get back in the map. I could set it when I get there, but I find it easier to set it all up first. I don't know, though, because am I going to attract tails for the other deliveries? Ah, screw it. Let's just wing it. Make it more interesting. All right. Let's go. But yeah, after I've done this run, Dom... We could do some biplane madness.
Ew, moi moi.
Right? Oh, wait. Update. Mission update. Deliver 9 units of gold. What? What gold? I got 21 units of gold, bro. Does that mean I'm going to get wrecked? Yeah, it does. Time to go. It's time to go. Aligning. Let's do it. So we've got an update. 9 units of gold to... What? The delivery location has been... What? What the hell? Go to
Zendi.
Yeah,
they changed the destination.
Yeah, but dude, they just changed the thing to where I just came from. What?
Yeah, good. You're gonna go back. They want it back.
They want the gold back and they'll pay me how much?
Did they give you a time limit?
Get out of here, you bastards! Sorry, I'm just having annoyance with this freaking chat button. Oh, bub. Okay. Back the way I came, please. Back the way I came. It's probably not even on the map, is it? Nope. So I got to go into galaxy map. Still no one here, luckily. Okay, so this is new. They made me go back the way I came. Weird. This has never happened before. So this could be where I get wrecked. Let's find out. Weird. They want me to jump back the way I came. What? Let me read that again. Get out of it! A bonus payment for the inconvenience. What? But they're only going to give me 45,000. I'd rather just go and deliver my mission to, you know, I'm going to get more money. Dear, oh dear. tie me kangaroo down, sport. How weird is this? Because they're not asking for all the gold back. They're just asking for, like, less than half of it back. It's a bit bizarre, mate. Okay. I didn't expect that. I was like, oh, well, 7 jumps to the destination. And then suddenly it's like, yeah, come back. We don't want you to do it anymore. What? Weird.
Definitely. But hey, if they are that stupid, give them.
Right? Let them have it. Chase the halo.
Only got one jump to go. And I'm full of fuel. Yay!
Being a dick. Oh good, it's on this side. Yep, there it is. Come on. Right. So weird. Like, one, I got one jump away. I'm glad I didn't get further away, I guess, but... two messages, but I can't see. Ah, shit. I went too far!
Bubble.
Ah, there's the door. Right. Keep overshooting. What the hell? You know what I just did?
What?
Forgot to ask permission to dock.
Oh yeah.
Yay, I got a trespassing fine. Screw you, viewer survey. 400 credits, are you serious? Right. My fault.
Permission denied.
Permission denied. Okay, how about now?
Clearance denied.
Okay, how about now?
What do you say? Shall I go to the Chameleon Nebula or the Coalsack Nebula?
Right, now we need to get in there because I'm getting shot at. And I'm travelling in reverse. What was that, buddy?
Shall I go to the Coalsack Nebula or the Chameleon one?
I don't know.
Well, the Chameleon is smaller, so I think it's going to be less frequently visited. I'm gonna pick based on that.
Where's landing 20?
Stop lagging.
They're really trying to screw me about.
I don't know why, but my game is down to 6 frames per second, and it's not fun to view the map this way.
Really? Why is that? Try changing the filters so there's less stars.
Okay.
That's all I can think of. I don't know. I have heard of that, though. If you get to the center of the galaxy, there's so many stars.
No, it didn't help. Probably it's another application.
Oh, right. Okay.
Yeah, my GPU load is up to 100. Something is eating my GPU.
Try relogging. It might be a... Oh my god, someone's getting wrecked.
But then when I come out, it's 30 FPS. So it was only the galaxy map. Weird.
Oh, the galaxy map is a very demanding tool within the game because it renders so many different particles.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna tone it down if
they should really simplify that map.
Yeah.
I mean, galaxy map quality low.
You know, you can filter out things so it only shows less data. Yeah.
Yeah, but it still tries to show data
standards.
Right. Okay, so what the hell am I doing now then? So I've just done that. Now what? This is so confusing when they throw a spanner like. See, how am I going to deliver 21 units of gold? I haven't got 21 units of gold anymore.
Great question.
Maybe I do. I don't know.
Oh yeah, reopening helped.
Wow, what's that? Is that a Type 9? A Type 9, I think, just landed next to me.
It's any time I go near the Chameleon Nebula. Anywhere else, it's fine.
Ah, it's the nebula, mate. Dude, the nebula's particle effect is killing you. That's what it is.
Yeah, but it doesn't do it at the Coalsack Nebula. Oh, wait, it does.
Wibble, wabble, wibble, wabble, wibble!
Yeah, wabble, wabble, wabble.
Okay, then on the way back, I'm gonna start searching for... Or white dwarfs.
Right, now I can get back to where the hell I wanted to go. Yeah! And guess what I forgot to do? Set my route. This is going to be good. Going to get shot down with a shitload of gold in my hold.
That's always good. I'm going to go up to galaxy vertical level 0. And look, there's an A-class.
Right, so now to get destroyed while in the galactic map trying to find my delivery location. Come on, system map. We need you. That one, please. Let's go. Lucky I did not die. Okay, there we go.
How far am I? I'm 1,100 light years away from the galactic center.
Oh, well done. Wait, what?
I mean, from the core, from the core.
I was gonna say, holy shit, how'd you get that far? I was like, damn, man, I thought you were just a little ways away.
I'm just exploring. No, I'm 1,100 from Seoul.
Why isn't the throttle stick working? Right, that's it.
Don't use the buttons.
I need a new one. Yeah, I just used WNS.
Don't use the buttons.
No, look. Forward, back. It's not working. Junk.
Well, then check your USB.
I think it's broken, mate. I think I need a new one.
Not going to do nothing, mate. It's not going to do Jeff.
To be honest, though, I might actually not bother with Actually, it was quite useful to have it. No, I would get another one. It's just a shame. I mean, it's...
Oh, my boy.
Screw it. I'll just ignore it. It's been a pain in the ass to set up since the you know, rebindings.
Did you turn off the chat thingy yet?
What chat thing?
The automatic jump to chat when you press 2.
No.
Okay.
But I'm kind of jumping my gold.
I know.
I gotta wait. I'll do it at the end of the stream if I do it, dude.
Okay.
Because I've got to deliver all my goods.
But Tom, you'll need a joystick if you wanted another driving game for planes and stuff.
Yeah, I know.
If you do that.
Yeah, you are right. But you'd probably get a wheel for that, wouldn't you?
Like I said, planes and stuff. Why would you have a wheel for planes and stuff?
Because it's fun. And that's how they did it in the Bowfighter.
Really? Oh yeah, you're right. They did have a wheel in a Bowfighter.
They just had a wheel in it. Because the pilots liked the wheel better than the joystick.
That's not allowed. They're just being
because
salty,
they were more used to it, you know. It's funny and salty at the same time.
So, in case you joined the stream late, there will be a video of this going up on YouTube with timestamps in it. Basically, we've been doing outer rim trading. So, it's sort of 130 light years for about 3 million. And that's not even with... That's only 50 cargo space, so... Or 40 cargo space. And that's what we've been doing. And I started with 10, but I think I'm going to end up with something around 15 million. So I need to just... It's easy, really. We're just trying to chill out. It's a very leisurely gameplay from trading. It's like you could fall asleep trading.
Although sometimes they do try to... wreck you.
Well, I was thinking about swapping into an asp and do some exploration, but when I tried to fit an asp out, it actually did. It wasn't as good as my type 6.
What did you get as jump range?
Less than the type 6. When fully
less
fitted.
Less than 26?
Yeah. I must have been doing
That's
something
weird.
Wrong. Must have been doing something wrong. I didn't have enough money
I'm gonna
to
check it on.
But the thing is, I didn't have enough money to fit it out properly because obviously I wanted to have a car. Whenever I discover a planet, I like to drive down there. You know, drive about, be like, yeah. You know, actually land
because
on it.
Oh,
hang on. I think there's someone after me, but I haven't seen him. Oh, wait, there he is. There's someone after me in a Sidewinder. So this is going to be really embarrassing if he kills me.
Scout or Explorer? Which one?
The Explorer is the one I tried.
Okay, let's...
It was really expensive as well. It was like 9 million.
Get it out as I would do it.
Because the thing is, like, the Type 6 handles like a Sidewinder when you're jumping. It's crazy. I don't understand that.
Right.
I love it. Please don't change. Kind of makes the brick like, you know, it's not attractive. You know, it doesn't look like a sexy sort of wedge like all the others do. I'd say the Type 6 is a bit like an F-150 Ford truck. It's just a workhorse, man. It's reliable. And it earns
sure
you
is.
Money. Yeah, like I tried the keelback. And to be honest... I like the idea of the keelback. And I'm guessing if you're doing smuggling runs, like, it'd probably be really good, but... I don't know. I just went back to the Type 6. Come on, mate. Is he still on me? No, he's gone. Quick. Race. D-scan, race. 40 new objects. God damn. I was wondering as well, right, for the exploration. If you go right down to the very bottom or the very top. Actually, no, right. Yeah, the very bottom. Because you can go down and up as well. If you go down to the very bottom, I think it'd probably be less likely. Holy crap, what's that? I think it'd be less likely to find people have been exploring down there.
Actually, they have.
Have they? Oh, okay.
Yeah. There was some who did that, yeah.
I guess people have... This is the trouble. The game's been out so long. All those sorts of ideas have been done.
But they more likely did a star route, you know, only a single line and back.
Yeah.
Because people are lazy like that. No offense, but learn to be a bit more creative with your stuff.
I'm not even paying attention.
For example, I did a kite formation.
Is this my last jump now? Out. Yeah, this is the last jump, I think. Yep, right, here we go. This is the part where I get my pants pulled down by some guy in a sidewinder. Woo! Side windows!
Put some more fuel in it, and what else do you need? Shields, AFMs, scoops, scanners. What else do you need?
That's it. Oh yeah, the planet. No. There's 2G hangar.
There is a free slot.
Dude,
so
you need to put the hangar. Yeah, you need to put the
car.
Yeah,
but I can't do it on Coriolis.
Yeah, you put the. Yeah, you can. Planetary hangar is in there, mate. It's on there. Yeah,
and
I'm sure.
And I'm just blind.
Yeah, because it's called something else. It's called, like, vehicle hangar.
Planetary vehicle hangar, yeah.
Yeah, there you go.
You can get a 2G or a 2H.
It's the light one.
One bay.
I always get the light one.
Yeah, the lightweight? Okay.
Yeah, it's only, like, 40,000 credits.
So the jump range is 34 to 31.3 light years.
What? That's huge.
And because I put in a 3C extra fuel tank...
Yeah.
You got 8 jumps out of it, 262 max range. And you have a 5C scoop.
Oh, I like that. That sounds like my kind of thing. Save that fitting. I want to take a look at it later.
So it kind of better?
Am I stuck at full throttle again? Yeah, I am. Thanks, joystick. I've just been going around and round and round in circles at full speed. Like,
I'm posting it in the channel. You can check it out later.
Yeah.
And see the powers table with all these. More than powers table.
Oh my god, that was making me dizzy. Right, here we go. I need to get in there.
And it only cost you 14 million off the bat.
14 million? Wow, I could buy one. And not even sell this ship.
Yep.
I think I'll do a bit more of this first. But I am thinking about getting out there doing a bit more.
But just
it's all
to know,
about the tourism,
you need 40
you know?
Million for an ASP Explorer.
Right.
So it's good to know your options, right?
Yeah.
So let's jump again. Full throttle and charging.
Oh, look! A mission update. Cobbles.
Let me guess, they want it back.
25,000 credits if you can land within a minute. Oh boy! It's just what I always wanted. Not pausing the game though, right. Is that the correct end? I really hope this is the correct end, because I'll have a lot of fun trying to... Why?
Turn over.
Right. Yeah, this is the right end. Okay, now remember.
It's easier to go 90 degrees to the pad and just pitch up, as I find, you know, because the sideways turning is so slow.
We're going in.
Boarding new astronomical objects.
What? Right, all the system pips, please.
Wow.
This is going to be a
and
rough
it's a
landing.
K-star.
I could
Holy
go a lot
macaroni.
Faster than this.
That's big. And it's undiscovered. Oh my, oh my. 7 gas giants.
Whoa!
A heck ton of moons.
Why am I hitting
and
my
four
chat?
Stars. A-M-L-L.
Hello? God damn but. You. I think I might have not done it. I don't know. It kept on going update. You didn't manage it. Annoyance.
Darn.
But then the thing is, they were going to give me 25,000 credits. I don't like the fact that they tell you about it as you come into the system. So it's like, well, you know, I mean, maybe I didn't see it. Maybe it came up earlier than that. I don't know. Right.
That could
anyway, it's kind of ridiculous because it's like, hey, we'll give you 25,000 extra credits if you land quickly, but it's worth like 600,000 the delivery. So do you really give a shit? Not really. It's a nice little fun challenge, you know what I mean, I guess?
Mm-hmm.
To try and land quick. And I think I only missed the window by a few seconds, to be honest.
Yeah, that happens more often than not.
But I've been like... In a way, the joystick kind of messes it up because I'm so used to playing on keyboard now. All right. So that was a considerable amount more money. So we've still got a couple more drops to make. So let's get to the next one. Next drop is at Kriegstein. Let's get going.
Restraints retracted. You may proceed when ready.
Do, do, do. And like I say, I think this is probably the easiest way to earn money in the game right now, because combat actually requires you to win, and there's a lot of things that can happen in combat that will screw you over, like an advanced wing coming to get you.
Although somebody likes the adrenaline of it.
Yeah, I suppose so. But then again, when you're being chased, there's the same rush from this.
Maybe. Maybe.
I think there is, because you know they're after you, mate.
Okay.
Like, you know they're after you. You can see the little dots, and they'll talk
but
to you.
But it's more passive, is what I meant.
Like, look, big haul like that. Surprised you made it this far, says Tav Evans.
Yeah, I love those.
Yeah, that's what he said to
and
me.
And I always reply, I will make it even further, thank you.
Do you? I never reply to them. If they were able to respond to me, I probably would, though.
It would be funny to have a little conversation with the AI.
Like a little bot.
Although I guess it's a long way down the road.
Well, the funny thing is, me and Dom used to use the Elite Voice, where you could control the game with voice commands and stuff. Look, I've got no throttle.
No voice attack, right?
No throttle. Yeah, voice attack. I'm at full throttle on the stick, but...
Nobody gives a damn.
It doesn't do anything. Yeah. Right, there we go. We're back.
And I'm just scanning the biggest system I found so far.
Basically, my joystick is wabble, and the throttle lever doesn't work anymore.
Because you're the best.
Oh, this cold's horrible. Video games are good for being ill. I'll say that much.
Time at all, yay!
So we need to go full speed, please. Why are you going so damn slow?
Because somebody's dragging you down.
What was that back there? There's nothing there. Oh, three pit. What? Three signatures. What are they? Anaconda, Type 9, Orca Keelback.
Oh my, still 30 degrees inside.
What's that? Are you melting again?
Yeah. Although by reducing the graphical quality...
Your room's not
by
as
a little
warm
bit,
now.
it's the video card is a bit more rested, yeah.
I thought you were going to say the room's colder now.
No, it's not. It's
now I'm not going into the map in Elite Dangerous on high graphics. It's colder in here.
I get 2 degrees colder. I'm playing on low settings, so I have to wear a jacket now.
You're the best around.
Every sun is shining in your face.
So I'm going to try and land on Kriegstein. I'm nearly there, guys. Wish me luck. There's quite a few signals.
You don't need it.
But I'm coming in like perpendicular to the shipping lane, so I think I've been lucky. But there is someone on my tail. It looks like he's too late.
My ear is melting.
Oh look, there's my landing pad. Thanks for keeping it warm for me, guys. Right. We're going in. There's no time. There's no time to slow down.
When you're too impatient and you need the one dock
shit.
To get to the pad.
Woo. Oh my god, that was brutal. Sometimes I like docking like an idiot. Drunk docking's fun, mate.
I guess so. Of course, it's behind me. Everything is behind me.
It's certainly quicker. I don't know. I don't reckon it looks as good, but in space, nobody can see you park like an idiot.
Something nobody like can see you scratch your paintwork. Yeah.
Yeah. Nobody can hear you grinding your ship along the station as you try to get it in a space.
Yeah, I actually came out in open play just to see some players,
and I
haven't seen any.
Which is why I don't.
I'm even going shields down because I like my ship cool.
Wow, shields down.
Yeah, I don't need that 21% consumption of my fuel.
You're mad.
Come on, mate.
Always take a shield, mate. Look, I use it to crash. It's very useful.
No, I have a shield.
Impact zones. Oh, right. Oh, as long as you got one. Well, you should do silent running then. If you're in silent running, they can't even
you can't
target
do silent
you.
Running on Super Cruise. But yes.
Oh,
although
okay.
There was once when I logged back in, you know, I always stop and go into low power mode, turning everything off. And when I came back in, two police, like security federal jump ships, came out of nowhere. Didn't even warn me, just flew past me and jumped out. And I was like, mate, I'm 400 light years away from anything. What do you do here?
Self-destruct, mate.
Look. An unidentified signal source. I wonder what it is. I mean, I get one for every 500 light years, so degraded emissions. Let's check it out. Maybe my third wreck in this tour.
A wreck? You find shipwrecks?
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah,
I found
shipwrecks on USS's.
I've never found one of them before.
You know, degraded emissions detected, threat zero. And also now they give you the engineer materials, not just the mission specific stuff. Because like reinforced alloy plates and these
kind of
stuff.
Yeah, I don't know what that's all about, mate. Look, I've got loads of stuff just knocking about.
You know, they had to make it,
under
so you
synthesis.
Have to farm the materials for the engineers.
Yeah, under synthesis, right?
That's materials. That's different.
Ah.
You have to mine those.
Well,
if you go one up
but look,
from
focus
there,
crystals.
You get datas.
Data, yeah.
And one up from there, you got materials.
Yeah,
there,
materials.
Like galvanizing alloys and mechanical equipment, mechanical
scrap.
Yeah, but
for what though?
For engineers, they want it to be turned into them because they craft from it, you know? It's used to level up your engineer reputation. Oh wow, that's a big one. That's a flippin' big one. Or it's multiple ships, I don't know.
It's beyond me, mate. I haven't done any of the engineer stuff. I should probably fly up to one and find out what the hell.
No,
they're...
I mean the wreckage.
They're like, I just heard that the engineers basically want you to pay them lots of money,
uh-huh.
So I was like, yeah, maybe that's for rich people then.
I mean, it looks like it can even be an anaconda, or even bigger. This is a huge ship. But it doesn't have anything to drop to me. Darn.
You're the best. Around! Oh. Are you gonna slow down or what? It's taking so long to slow down. It's just being stubborn at this point.
Yeah, it has these imperial lines, you know, the nice smooth edges.
Yeah.
I don't know, it may be an imperial, which is the biggest imperial ship.
Clipper?
Hey, I found something.
What'd you find?
Why can't I select this?
You're wabbling so hard right now.
Sorry.
He's like, what is this? Oh my god, it's something else. I don't know what it is. Hey guys, I can see something right now that you can't.
Oh, I turned my scanners off.
You and your obsession with energy efficiency, I swear to God.
I know.
You're going to get yourself killed.
It's like, a canister of small survey data.
It's like I asked, for, hey Martin, are there any players in your sector? No, there's nobody here. Oh wait, my scanners are off again.
Yeah. You know what I do with illegal salvage? Ramming speed!
Access permitted. Please land on designated pad number 08.
Wow. That hurt my AFMS 3%. Well, who gives a darn about it?
Might want to slow down a bit. Oh shit! Okay, that was pretty. That was greasy. That was. Well, I suppose if we're gonna drunk dock, then we may as well drunk dock. I'm not feeling too well, you know.
Yeah, I'm really well.
I said stop engines.
Turn them off. Turn it off.
I'm losing the ability to. To do things. There we go. Yeah, I do prefer the 1.5 million run. All of this going from station to station really eats into your efficiency.
Right.
But yeah, I got my target. I think once I've sold this, I'll be over 15 million. And I've got a 10 million hauler already, so if I trade it in, I'm not even, you know...
So. Awesome.
Good stuff. 20 owned units of gold. There you go. I'm up to 15,520. Beautiful. Right.
Let's go to the next one.
See if they want to buy my. Doesn't really matter. Just sell it.
Also, the galaxy, you know, the galactic center looks so. Lot more orangish out here.
Oh really? I've never been out that far. We might do a long range. Maybe we'll do a long range mission. See how far we can get. I mean, I've just earned what was it, 15 million in 2 days. So I think maybe I can take a break from.
I'm coming backwards, so might as well.
Yeah, maybe we should give a visit to those engineers as well. See what that's about.
You should definitely, because they're all on planets.
Oh, okay, so you can't even do it then, lol.
I mean, I can escort you.
Yeah.
Not like you need it or something.
I think we're going to sign off there, guys. So basically, thanks for watching. Sorry about my throat. I got a bit of a cold today.
Mine as well.
And we'll be back with more Elite Dangerous soon right here. Thanks for watching. See you next time.
Bye.